Perfect. So we're carrying on from where we left off in the last episode, which we are currently in this particular dungeon here. It's Fort Amol Prison. Well, it's part of the Fort Amol dungeon itself. We're basically going to try to clean up this dungeon here. And with that, I mean, you want to kill the people that basically occupied the dungeon here. Took over the dungeon. Right, is there anything useful in here? No, I don't think so. Except for beds and so forth. Now, you might, of course, find some stuff in here that could still be useful. That's kind of what I'm hoping for. Other than that, is there any use for this? Yes, I know I can level up. I know. Nope. Other than the beds, there is absolutely nothing useful here. Right, I've opened up all the doors except for this one. Let's just check out the last one. No, they're all exactly the same. Anyways. Damage is still on the wall. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go into the rest of that fort. Red mountain flower. Is there more here? I'm not sure. Okay, let's just check out how we can actually get through here. Corpse I hadn't actually seen before. Okay. Alright, let's get into here. At least I should have my fireball ready to blast at them as soon as possible. It's a bit of a mage battle again for you. Alright, let's switch over to the correct spells. I'm gonna use the regular fire. My mana is regenerating in the meantime. I should have taken care of one more of them. At least with just the one left in here. Alright. I'm fully healed up. Just the one mage remaining, it looks like. Blue mage robes. Let's have a look what these would potentially do for me. Blue mage robes. So it does the same thing, but it looks cooler. Stuff. Bone meal. Oop, oop, oop. Cannas root, not to be forgotten. Search through the cupboard. There's always interesting stuff to be found in there. Thistle root. Okay, let's just try to get this open as quickly as we can. There we go. Lockpicking has increased to level 24. Steel dagger. Right. Is that, what is that? Looks like a, is that a bug? No, it must be. Well, let's get these mushrooms. Should probably have switched over to a different spell at some point. Anyways, we're not too far off from where he was just a second ago. Ooh, there's a coin here on the floor. Luckily we had a quick save that we did. Go outside briefly, just heal up and replenish, of course, our mana. Now, since he's a fire mage, ideally, of course, want to use something other than what I'm using at the moment, fire. But yeah, given what I've got at the moment, actually, what I could do, I could basically calm him, couldn't I? Should really work. I knew it was empty anyway, so gold coins.
Must be my imagination.
Yes, it's your imagination. It's a very, very vivid one. Cool. It took a bit of effort. Gods and worship. White cap. Yes, I could do with some sleep. I might do that in a minute. Let's first deal with all that we've got here. Deathbell Apprentice Fire Mage. The Nords of Skyrim. Okay. Search through the cupboard, see what's in there. Search through the chest. Magical regeneration. Ropes of minor conjuration. Okay, interesting. End table. Coin purse. The Talos mistake. Interesting. Book of Daedra. Dresser to search through, and really nothing other than that hat that's in there that intrigues me. The key reason I want to take the hat is because I want to be able to enchant them at some point. Ooh, the man made of the reach. Cool. And frost salts. Is that it? It does look like it, doesn't it? Because I'm leaving all of these naked corpses lying around. Anything that I've forgotten in here? I don't think so, but yeah, just to be on the safe. Let's actually go through the list of ingredients we got here. Never actually done anything with that one, as you can see. Karasut, I've never done anything with. Death Bell. Dragon's Tongue. Fire Salt. Frost Salt. Hagraven Claw. Feathers. Honeycomb. As you can see, exposing myself to a whole lot of potential damage. But yeah, it's sometimes a part of the game, isn't it? Yep. I'm covered in damage now, as you can see. But it's only temporal damage, or temporary damage, I should really say, not temporal, because that means it's an element of the timeline. Anyways, let's make our way to the outside. Let's do a check on my inventory. 227. A shrine? No, it kind of looks like a shrine, but it is not. Alright, where are we at the moment? Let me just go back to the map and then click on the local or the regional. Yes, we're at this fortress, which is... Ooh, actually haven't been in here yet. Clothes, another chest. Wardrobe. Anything else I have not done yet here that I need to do? I don't think so. Nope, I've cleared out the fortress, which was the key objective here. Well, it wasn't really my original objective, but it kind of became my objective. But that's fine. Let's see, I need to head over to, yes, the direction I'm heading in now, which is perfect. Making my way into here. There's another vein there, which is fine. What's that? A skull of some sort. Creep cluster, wow. Interesting stuff we come across here.
You're not afraid you'll set fire to something?
Hello.
Huh? Need something?
Yeah. Just find it funny to find you guys lying here in the water like that. That's all. Looks funny. Right. I think we're almost at the entrance now. Dragon's Tongue. So that's where those come from, and there's more that creeper stuff here, and more dragon's tongue. There's a whole raft of resource I can use for the purpose of my alchemy that I actually didn't have before. Not sure what kind of plant this is. No, that's nothing. More dragon's tongue. It looks to be a really local resource. Dragon's tongue. care of that wolves as well, or those wolves, I should really say. Didn't expect to see any wolves here. Ah, look at that, there is actually a dragon here. Who is he attacking though? Is he attacking anyone? Not sure. Shelter behind the rocks like this. Shouting back at him. He's not really suffering too much damage, it looks like. There he is. Oh, hold on. Highborn ability available, that'd be great, but I had used that at my last dungeon and I haven't actually rested since. Right, let's have a look. Actually, what I can do, I can actually level up. Let's go for more magic. Let's get a little bit more health. Now, one of the things I had wanted to increase, of course, was my speech. Let's have a look at the magic spells I got. Have I got only... Ooh, I got sparks. Sparks doesn't do much, unfortunately. You might already have noticed. Right, my size of my magic reserve is significantly bigger. Look at the damage to the stuff here. Wow. Hold on, it's not fair. That's not fair. You're flying. Of because I'm not able to fly, which doesn't really make this fair, but anyways, we have to be able to defeat the dragon anyways. Some open space to be able to attack now. Where is he? Come on. Don't have to hide like that. Oh, there you are. Hit him a couple of times, which is good. Just need to make sure I stay alive as well. Over me. Just a substantial landing, I guess. Again. Probably what I should get is lightning, or some form of lightning spell. It would make my life a bit easier, wouldn't it? Angles or change directions in unexpected ways. Helps me stay alive. Oh boy. That was like a passing attack. Coming around this rock. He is scorching the rocks though, but it's fine. Better the rocks than him scorching me. Frustration keeps on increasing. Which makes sense with the continuous healing that we're applying to ourselves. Setting it back to the fireball mode. What? What? Are you fleeing? No. Has he left me? No. So spend a lifetime fighting him? Our friend the dragon? And then he leaves. That's not nice. I can probably pull him out by going to his lair. blacksmith's just over there. Where I should be able to pick up another. Oh, there he is again. It means he's healed himself already in part, which isn't really nice. Mr. Dragon fleeing and then healing himself, which is kind of the tactic I'm using as well. But from here, I should be. Should really be, but can't guarantee it. Look at that, he's actually attacking the giants over there. Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Not the dragon this time. Not the dragon this time, it looks like. Absorb the extra soul, which is fine. Good. If I only can get rid of the giants that's chasing me at the moment. Hopefully will leave me alone. Hopefully. I of course did not attack him, but I don't know how they will think, those giants. Adding another word here to it. Word of power learned, frost breath. One of the things that we are aware of around the this place, it's typically littered with some kind of treasures as well. I haven't come across the treasure here yet. Ah, there it is. The big chest. Hide boots. Okay. Dare come up here? He does, doesn't he? Narrow ledges, he doesn't like, looks like. kill them. What's he got an offer though? Look at that. A giant toe, wolf pelt, garnet, my boots, and an orc tusk. Has this had any consequence for any of my statuses? Now there is a status section here. I don't see any influence with the giants as such, so I think everything is fine. I would think everything is fine. Iron ore. More dragon's breath. Let's go back to where we had intended to go.
Mind yourself with that fire. Don't burn anything down now.
All right, hire a thug.
Hey.
Yes. What do you want? Why are you getting aggressive against me? Come on, my friend. You're getting aggressive against me. I can hopefully take you on. Why is a hired thug after me? Right, I took that first one down here somewhere, didn't I? I can't find his body anymore. Okay, I blasted him this way, I think. What if people don't like me here? Boom. The saber cat died as well. Contract. Interesting. Interesting indeed. Let's have a look at the actual new ingredients that I've got here. Is there any listing of the new ones? No, I don't think so, is there? Kind of have to go through them one by one to some extent. And then we got the books here. Miscellaneous items. Now what can I get rid of? Because I'm of course overburdened, as you can see. That's a poor value. It's for value on us all. I'm still 5 overweight. That's even poorer value. Whew. Alright, there we go. We're backward in the weight range I should be. Let's now read the actual note, the contract that we actually had here. Here's agreed upon amount. I expect you to faithfully carry out your request to teach a lesson to the thief, Sonelias. You need not kill him, but I have no qualm about if you deem it necessary. Hulda. Who's Hulda? I'm not sure who Hulda is. Either way, I was on the way towards the Nature's Blessing quest location, which is still right in front of me, and I got distracted by that dragon, which then ultimately led me to get into an encounter with a giant, and ultimately in an encounter with thugs. Let's get back to where we were supposed to be going. Oops, more dragon's breath here. Or dragon's tongue, sorry. More of it. Perfect. Entrance should be, I guess, up here somewhere. No, so down on the other side. So what I'll do, I'll make my way towards the entrance here. There we go. We're at the entrance to the sanctuary. I'm not actually going to go in yet. I'm actually going to keep that for the next episode. But before we do that, we probably have to travel back to town first. So what I'm going to say is thanks again for joining me. I'm going to save away the game here into my new save games. And yeah, hopefully I'll see you on the next episode. In the meantime, have a good day. Bye-bye.